Edie, I got to tell you, this has just been an impressive sight all day. The river is so high now, the Sacramento River, it comes basically to the top of the weir. That's why it is flowing through the rear. Now, in order for them to open this all the way up, the river has to rise 2 more feet. Until that happens, the water's having a big impact on things like parks, trails, and marinas. 25 feet and rising. The Sacramento and American rivers are so high, it's closed the bike trail and forced runners and cyclists to find another route.
It's a big change in the direction. I have to go through town.
Levee patrols continue as water officials monitor the situation closely.
The amount of water is, it's almost unfathomable.
Along the Sacramento River, boat owners had to move their cars as the water quickly rose.
That's 5 feet it came up.
So you had to move your car, basically, in the middle of the night.
Oh, yeah, everybody.
You can't see it, but that's a parking lot, 5 to 12 feet underwater at this marina in Yolo County. The water rose so much that they had to take a new dock, cover this dock, and this goes straight to the levee. And in West Sacramento, Gregory Avenue was closed because of this. Part of the road was washed away when this drainage canal started to back up. In order to fix this before the next storms come, a big 65-foot plate has to be put over the top here so residents can use the road. Now, the water hasn't been this high in quite a while. DWR officials are concerned of what happens over the next couple days, not only from the rain we get, but from the snow they get in the Sierra. They're also very concerned that if a couple of warm storms come through, a lot of that snow in the Sierra will melt and make the rivers rise even farther. Keep in mind, they just started releasing more water from Shasta Lake today. Live in Yolo County, I'm Richard Sharp, KCRA 3 Report.